subscribe, and hit the bell icon to never miss another update. Welcome to our channel. Today we'll discuss on debugging an Arduino program and designing an Android app on MIT App Inventor. Here we have a program on rotating a circle by 180 degree by using raindrop sensor. We have written the program and we'll see if there is any code, any bug in this program. If we see the top of the thing, we can see the starting statement, and if we compile it, as the program is being compiled, we can see if there is any kind of errors out there or it's been compiled very successfully. The sketch is being compiled right now and we found a bug in this program. At the initialization of layout of number 11 of Arduino, we can see we missed a semicolon after number 11, and we can see expected comma or semicolon before void. That's why the statement is not being fulfilled successfully, so it's showing a bug. If you put a semicolon on that, we can see it gets properly successful in this case. We are compiling this project. Now we can see another bug. We made the spelling mistake of pin mod. It will be cap M. Now we are making this successfully again. Oh, another point I missed. Another semicolon missing. Compiling this program again. The sketch is being compiled again. Another spelling mistake of digital write. We say digital write was not declared in the scope. Digital write in that case, the spelling mistake we made, the W of this case will be capital. The semicolon after high, we even missed that thing again. Compiling this project, we can see if there's any other bug out there. The spelling mistake of serial, capital S, small e, r, I, a, l. Retype it as S, e, r, I, oh, spelling mistake again. It would be capital S, e, r, I, a, l. Now it's completely right. If we compile this project again, we can see. Oh, another mistake, another mistake. Expected constructor, destructor or type conversion before second bracket token at the bottom of the debugging statement. So there we can see the second bracket ends over there, and this second bracket has no ending, so it's extra. Now if you see the rightmost second bracket of third last line, we can see it ends after void loop, the void loop starts. Now we see it's properly successful, and now when we compile this project again, we can see the sketch is being compiled. Now we can see as the program is properly compiled, we can even go to the tools and change the board as Arduino Genuino Uno to Nano to Lilypad or something else we want to make. Here we used Arduino Genuino Uno, and we can even change the port as the board is connected with the computer, and then we can upload this program onto the Atmega 328P microcontroller processor of the Arduino board. In this way, Arduino program has been made. Heading towards the another video, we can see how an Android app is designed on MIT App Inventor platform. First, go to the MIT App Inventor site and create your Gmail account. Sync your Gmail account to this account and start creating an Android app. Here, there we see a list picker to four buttons respectively, and we have to create a proper background image for the screen for this Android app, and the screen is scrollable. We're uploading a pre-uploaded file from our program and uploading that to our app. There we got it. And then we see a very beautiful background of our application that we are going to use. For the list picker, we can even change the background color to gray, and it's properly highlighted in this case. And respectively, off and on buttons of appliance 1 and appliance 2, we are using .png files so that it seems very beautiful. Using the off.png file so that it seems very beautiful in case of off and on statement of appliance 1 and appliance 2 respectively. File is being uploading off.png to the App Inventor server. The file has been uploaded, and for the off button we have another file that's very beautiful even in this case. Oh, it's actually .jpg file, sorry, we have to go for .png file. Oh, not even this one. Where's the thing? The power of icon.png, the file we are finding. So for appliance 1 and appliance 1, off and on switches are complete. And for appliance 2, the same thing is going to be repeated again. For appliance 2, on button, and for off button, we have the same jp.png file we use in case of appliance 2. There we have the user interface UI of our Android app that we are going to use. Appliance 1, the label. We have an appliance to the level we have on the bottom of it. We can even change the font to font bold, font italic. We can even change the font as default sans serif. We are using sans serif right now. Even we can change it to monospace serif, to whatever we want to. Yeah, now this one is serif. We can even change the font size, font bold, anything we want to. On the bottom of it, we can see our team, copyright team, RPS 2 or PRS 2, whatever you say. Text color goes to red, which is very prominent and seems very highlighted in this case, and it's seeming very good. And so highlighting. Heading towards the block section or logic block section, we have a logic statement blocking. When list picker 1, the Bluetooth connection list picker is selected. Bluetooth client address picks the list picker 1 selection. And respectively, when button 1 and button 2 and button 3, button 4 are pressed, the Bluetooth client is sending very perfect codes respectively 1, 0, 1, 2, and 3. In this way, the H05 module of Arduino gets the code, and Arduino analyzes the data and performs very particularized action. In this way, the app works, and it's very simple. You can see call Bluetooth client 1 sends text 0 when button 2 is clicked. And when the button is click level 5, text color is changed to magenta, and respectively all other things out there. So this way the block statement works. And we can even change the logic if we need to according to our project, and we can even build the project provided QR code for APK for downloading, and we can even save the app in our computer.apk file as we think about. Smart automated progress bar compiling part 2, place where it's been compiling 50% and 10% preparing application icon that we gave it for. Compiling parts 2, please wait, 34% is ongoing right now. 85%, preparing final package. Now simply save the .apk file installing your Android device. Thanks for watching.